What's up, everybody? Andrew Mahone here with Darium's Competitive Pokemon, back with another expanded deck profile. Today, we are going to be talking about Drampa Garbodor. Drampa Garbodor is an archetype that has seen a lot of success in the past standard format, and I think it's going to port very well into expanded format too. Drampa Garbodor kind of took the format by storm, winning the North America International Championships this past year, also placed very well at the World Championships, and has not had a chance to really debut in expanded format yet. I think it's going to catch a lot of players by surprise having to combat Trash Lance Garbodor in expanded format. A lot of expanded format decks are very item dependent and item reliant, and I think Drampa Garbodor stands a pretty good shot at doing well the upcoming expanded regional championship. So this deck gets a few new tricks in the expanded format. Going to be talking about those and the various options for building your Drampa Garbodor list. However, I think that Drampa Garbodor goes largely unchanged from standard moving into expanded. So it's a good choice for anybody who is very comfortable with this deck in standard format. Maybe not quite as experienced with expanded format. You could pretty much take this deck and do pretty well, you know, all things considered, even if you don't have a lot of expanded experience, just because this deck doesn't get a whole lot changed heading into expanded format. So let's go ahead and talk about the list. We start off with two copies of Drampa GX. We also play three copies of Trash Lance Garbodor, one copy of Garbotoxin Garbodor, and four Trubbish. There are a variety of different Trubbishes that we have available to us in the expanded format. There's one that has 60 hit points that allows you to put a card from your discard pile on top of your deck. If you have one of those, or if you have access to them, you might want to play a split where you maybe play one of those kinds of Trubbishes. However, the 60 hit points is a little bit of a pain. However, it does have a retreat cost of one as well. So it can be a nice option to have just in case you want to get out of a dead draw or something like that. You can pop a Verse Seeker back on top of your deck. You can see here I have the four Tried and True Acid Spray Trubbish. These are good ones, but there is also a Tool Drop Trubbish, which does more damage based on the amount of tools that are in play. Tool Drop Trubbish, its attack costs a psychic and a colorless, so if you were to be playing maybe Espeon Garb, where you might play Dimensional Valley or Dimension Valley, that might be a better option, Trubbish, in that deck. But the Acid Spray Trubbish is still valid, nice for removing energy from the opponent, does 10 damage, can be boosted with Choice Band as well, and still a valid inclusion. So just wanted to make you guys aware of the various options for Trubbish. There are quite a few. Take a look if you have the time online just to see the different ones that you have available to you if you plan on building this deck. Moving on, we play three copies of Tapu Lele GX, one Giratina promo, and one Oricorio to round out the cast. Drampa is obviously our primary attacker here. It's very good with that Righteous Edge attack. I mean, Righteous Edge is super, super powerful, not only in standard format, but also in expanded format. Being able to remove double colorless energies from opposing Seismitoad EX, from Mega Rayquaza, is just a great ability. Also can remove double colorless energies from opposing Drampa. Being able to remove special energy in expanded format is very good, and Righteous Edge continues to be valuable in expanded, especially versus Seismitoad. Just continuously removing that double colorless energy really, really disrupts that deck's primary strategy. So Righteous Edge, good against that. Also good against Trevenant Break decks. Trevenant Break runs a lot of mystery energy, and even, you know, maybe a copy of double colorless energy or two in order to use Necrozma GX's attack. Righteous Edge, it can be valuable against that deck as well, just to bump those mystery energies and make it harder for them to stream powerful, you know, Silent Fear attacks. Drampa's Berserk attack, obviously going to be your primary damage dealing attack, especially early, until your opponent gets enough items in the discard pile to power up Garbodor's Trash Lance. And then Big Wheel GX is an excellent consistency boost, especially during the first turn of the game in expanded format. It could give you just a nice thing to use to draw out of a dead hand, can just allow for powerful turn one, turn two setups. Big Wheel GX, an amazing GX attack, and an excellent option to have in this deck. We also play three copies of Tapu Lele GX. Three copies works fine in this deck. We do have more search cards in expanded format than we do have in standard. So some of these lists, we're playing four copies of Tapu Lele GX. In standard, I think three is completely fine in expanded, especially since we run computer search in this list. So three is totally cool. You don't really need the fourth one that you might have played in standard format. Obviously, Wonder Tag, an excellent ability for searching out your one of supporters, especially on the first turn of the game, being able to grab powerful supporters like Getsis, grab your one of Hexmaniac if you can't get your Garbodor out into play. Being able to grab teammates, Wonder Tag works wonders in this deck as it does in most decks in both standard and expanded format. Energy Drive is also a valuable attack to have for this deck, pumps out just a nice vanilla amount of damage with a double colorless energy, which we run four of. In combination with Choice Band, you can do a pretty decent amount of damage with Energy Drive to complete some two-hit knockouts if, you know, your opponent does not have enough items in the discard pile for you to knock them out in one go with Garbodor, or if maybe you missed the one-hit knockout with Drampa GX's Berserk. We also have access to Tapu Cure GX in this deck, which is extremely valuable versus decks like Trevenant. If you didn't need to use your big wheel to set up versus Trevenant, Tapu Cure GX can really save you. If you have two highly damaged GXs on the bench or two highly damaged Pokemon on the bench, Tapu Cure GX can really help bail you out of those situations just for a single psychic energy. So a great option to have. We also play one copy of Oricorio. Oricorio is here for that Night March matchup. You're going to use it for the Supernatural Dance attack. And it reads, for each Pokemon in your opponent's discard pile, put one damage counter on your opponent's Pokemon in any way you like. So, obviously, if your opponent is loading up Night Marchers in the discard pile, we're not playing Karen in this list. Instead, our strategy is going to be to try and stream Trashalanche Garbodors and then finish the game with a Supernatural Dance for multiple prizes. So that is going to be our main strategy against the Night March, and it is fairly effective. Oricorio really goes a long way, especially since you can rescue Stretcher it back. Same with this Giratina promo, which is here for that Trevenant matchup, the Trevenant Break matchup, and also can come in handy versus Greninja Break, because you can get Garbodor activated versus Greninja Break. You also have Hexmaniac for Greninja Break, and then if your opponent is able to Field Blower or Tool Scrapper's kind of, you know, obsolete at this point, or Startling Megaphone your Garbodor, you can still have Giratina on the bench so that your opponent really has no way to use Giant Water Shriek. And so this is a very valuable card, really sweetens your Trevenant Break matchup as well as your Greninja Break matchup. And when you can sweeten two matchups that are pretty prevalent in expanded format for just one card slot, really can't complain with that. Obviously, we do play three copies of the Trashalanche Garbodor. Trashalanche is just such a powerful attack. It is really, really, really strong. For just one psychic energy, it is so easy to set up, and expanded decks really toss their items away, you know, very, very quickly. I mean, we have things like Battle Compressor, Trainer's Mail, there's Acro Bike, Level Ball, Computer Search. There are so many items, you know, at the opponent's disposal to use, and most decks in expanded are just so fast and so powerful. Most rely heavily on a turbo kind of engine with Shaman EX to really set up and draw through multiple cards, you know, multiple sets of hands on the first turn of the game. Trashalanche really ramps up relatively quickly against a lot of decks in expanded format. Obviously, Trashalanche is still not very good against the likes of Gardevoir GX that can Twilight GX its items back into the deck. However, they're not, you know, Gardevoir is not quite as prevalent in expanded format yet as it is in standard format. I think Gardevoir GX does have some promise in expanded format, so that is something to look out for with this deck. However, that being said, most expanded decks, very item reliant. Trashalanche is going to go a long way against the majority of expanded decks. And then, of course, we do play one copy of the Ability Garbodor, the Garbotoxin Garbodor, just to shut down abilities. This can be really good against decks like Gardevoir, really good against Raikou, also good against Night March. I mean, just being able to stop their Shamans and so on and so forth, being able to stop Marshadow, even though Night March is probably not going to bench Marshadow. There are going to be some decks that are going to run Marshadow in expanded format because it's just such a cool toolbox card in combination with that Battle Compressor. Being able to turn off Marshadow can be valuable in this deck as well. So just a good all-around card, shuts off Tapu Lele, shuts off a lot of draw engines as well, you know, stops Greninja Break from Giant Water Shuriken. There is just so many uses for this ability, Garbodor, in expanded format, and I think that this deck is very well rounded to take on expanded format. So that's it for the Pokemon. Let's move on to the supporters. As far as the supporters go, we play 4 copies of Professor Juniper, 1 copy of Colress, 3 copies of N, 1 copy of Bridget, 1 copy of Hexmaniac, 1 copy of Getsis, 1 copy of Teammates, 1 copy of Lysander, and 1 copy of Guzma. So you can see I play a lot of one ofs. I think that there are just so many powerful one of supporters in expanded format. So why not take advantage of all of them? I really like the options of just being able to go for what you want with Tapu Lele and then retrieve it with Versus Seeker. I mean, and throughout the game, look at how many options we have. Obviously, we have our staple draw supporters here. You know, we have been over these and we know why we play 4 copies of Juniper. We know why we play, you know, 2 to 3, maybe even 4 copies of N. I think 4 is probably overkill in expanded. However, I've seen some lists go as low as 2 here, and that is acceptable most of the time. We do play 1 copy of Bridget, great for the first turn of the game, being able to get your Trubbish and your Drampa out of the deck and into play as early as possible. Play 1 copy of Hexmaniac, which is just there in case you don't have your Garbotoxin Garbodor up. Sometimes you're going to be needing to use your Trash Lance Garbodors over and over again, and you can't afford to evolve one of your Trubbish into the Ability Garb because you want them all to be Trash Lance Garbodors, and then you're going to Rescue Stretcher to evolve into more Trash Lance Garbodors, but you might still want to shut off your opponent's abilities. So Hexmaniac is there for that reason. It can really stop decks, you know, dead in their tracks. If you do turn 1 Hexmaniac against a deck like Mega Rayquaza, that can be very powerful. If you do a turn 1 Hexmaniac versus a deck like Turbo Darkrai, that's going to be very powerful as well. Kind of going hand in hand with Getsis. Now, Getsis is also an extremely powerful turn 1 supporter. You can turn 1 Getsis versus a deck like Night March to great effect, versus a deck like Mega Rayquaza, and versus decks like Turbo Dark. So I think that because a card like Getsis, you know, even against Trevenant Break, being able to go turn 1 Getsis going first, you might get them out of the items that they needed in order to draw and set up appropriately, so Getsis can be powerful there too. I think Getsis can really catch your opponent off guard in expanded format. You know, if they're sitting on a Versus Seeker just waiting to retrieve a supporter for the next turn, you can bump it out of their hand and maybe your opponent is just caught off guard and, you know, it starts to dead draw because you knocked their only Versus Seeker out of their hand. Getsis just so good, especially early, makes this deck a lot more aggressive having the option to go for a turn 1 Hex or a turn 1 Getsis, and even just nice disruption options to have throughout the course of the game. We play 1 copy of Colress. Colress is my favorite supporter in expanded format, and this is a card that I just miss so much in standard format. Being able to shuffle your hand into your deck and draw the amount of cards equal to the amount of bench Pokemon on both yours and your opponent's side is an extremely powerful effect. I mean, throughout the course of the game, you're going to find turns where you can Colress for 9 or 10 cards very easily. If you're playing against a deck like Mega Rayquaza that fills their bench up to 8, then you can Colress for even more cards to have even more powerful turns where you hit, you know, even more cards that you would need in order to set up and play. So I think Colress extremely powerful in this deck. Really like it in here. And I think it's powerful in every deck in expanded format and would play it in most of my lists that fill their bench up to 5, which Garbodor definitely tends to do. We also play a copy of Teammates. Teammates is really good for just streaming your Trash Lance Garbodor, especially against decks that knock out your Garbodors in one go very quickly, like Night March. Even good against decks like Raikou, you know, anything that's going to be taking down your Trash Lance Garbodors, and you want to just continue to get Trash Lance Garbodors into play, Teammates is going to help you do that. You can search for your Rescue Stretcher and a Psychic Energy, and really that's all you need. Once you turn one, bridge it, get your Trubbish into play, then you can evolve into Trash Lance Garbodor, get your Psychic, and then you can Teammates a couple times to just get, you know, Rescue Stretcher Psychic Energy or Trash Lance Garbodor Psychic Energy, and then you can Teammates, and just continue to stream Trash Lances, you know, after you set up with Bridget on the first turn of the game. Teammates is really good for that. Teammates is also very good for being able to set up your Drampa's big Berserk attack. You can search out a Rainbow Energy in order to place 10 damage onto one of your bench Pokemon and a Choice Band, and then you can get going relatively easy with Drampa's Berserk attack thanks to Teammates. We do play a split of Lysander and Guzma here. I think that both have their merits and both are pretty valuable. I think that sometimes, you know, you just need the Lysander for game and you might not have a Float Stone in play, you know, after an end a low. So I like the option of being able to have both, and you could just choose whichever one you want with Versus Seeker throughout the course of the game. Guzma, obviously very valuable, just being a switching card. You know, a lot of times you are going to have a Float Stone in play because we do play four of them. However, I think Lysander, you know, just is going to get you there in those situations where you don't happen to have a Float Stone in play, and I like to play one of them just for that reason alone. That's it for the supporters. So let's move on to the item cards. We play four copies of Versus Seeker in order to retrieve our plentiful one of supporters. Four copies of Ultra Ball, very consistent, obviously, to search out your Pokemon. Four copies of Float Stone to activate, not only to activate Garbodor's Garbotoxin, but also to give this deck some much needed mobility. Four copies of Float Stone is an absolute must for me in any sort of Drampa Garb deck. Play three copies of Choice Band to boost our damage output to get Drampa over that 150 damage bump up to 180, which is just great numbers versus most Pokemon EX and Pokemon GX. Play two copies of Rescue Stretcher in order to retrieve our Garbodors from the discard pile and stream them easier. We can also use it to get a Tapu Lele out of the discard pile if you need to search for a supporter in the middle of the game. Rescue Stretcher is just an extremely useful, utility driven card, and I love it in this deck. It just goes very well with the entire synergy of the list. Two copies of Field Blower. Field Blower is just great for removing things like Fighting Fury Belt, which is very popular, and also cards, also stadium cards from the opponent. You can remove, you know, Mega Rayquaza's Skyfield, but is just great for removing tool cards and putting them into the discard pile, and then therefore powering up your Trash Lance even further. So Field Blower, must have in this deck. Gonna play two copies of it and one copy of Computer Search. You could play a Dowsing Machine in here. I just love the consistency of Computer Search, getting exactly what you need when you want it, right when you need it. It's always a live card. I'm gonna make the same argument for Computer Search in almost every deck. You could play a Dowsing Machine, but I'd ask you, you know, like, what are you really getting back? There's not really enough one of cards in this deck, or enough valuable cards that you play four of that you wish you could play five of, to really warrant playing a Dowsing Machine. In a deck like Turbo Darkrai does play Dowsing Machine sometimes, and that's because you might want to get an extra Hypnotoxic Laser, or an extra Dark Patch, or an extra Max Elixir. You don't really need to do anything like that in this deck, so one copy of Computer Search is just fine. So let's move on to the energy. All right, and for the energy, we play three copies of Psychic Energy, four copies of Rainbow Energy, and four copies of Double Colorless Energy. Rainbow Energy is here to power up Drampa's Berserk attack. This is the same strategy that Torge used in the North American International Championships in order to get that attack going. You could also play Potown or Team Magma's Secret Base if you wanted to just find an alternative way, maybe a quicker way in order to power up Drampa's attack. You could use one of those options. I've just, you know, decided to go with the Rainbow Energy because it's, you know, what many players were using at the World Championships, as well as what Torge used his North American International Championship list. Play three copies of Psychic Energy. You could play a fourth here. You know, that would be fine too. I'm okay with that. Maybe take out the third N as a free space that we have in order to accommodate for that. But three works just fine, and we play four copies of Double Colorless Energy in order to power up Tapu Lele's attack as well as Drampa's attack just much easier. So That's it for our Drampa Garb list. Thank you for checking out the video. Let me know what you think of Drampa Garb in the comments below. Like the video, subscribe to the channel. Peace out.